Welcome, my friends, to Glorious Nippon. Aw, how do I get those? Is there like a secret block here somewhere? Is there a way I can like... Aw, what was that? It, like, it collected some of the coins and then it bounced off of them. That's so weird. Alright, I'm probably not... Man, that's some weird physics on that coin collecting. Oh well. I'm not gonna actually try to get all of those. Man, this is definitely weird for a Mario game. Including a level inspired by Japan. There's a level in Super Mario 3D World for the Wii U that was like a Japanese I don't know what the word is, a Japanese temple of some sort, and I thought that was really weird. It's like, I mean, Mario is like, in most Mario games, there's absolutely no indication that the game actually came from Japan. So it's weird to actually see that. Oh god! I didn't realize that thing would take more than one hit. Alright, well, we reached a checkpoint, but unfortunately we are still tiny. See, I really want to kill that thing, because I'm sure there's going to be something good in those blocks. Alright, sucker. Oh my god! How many hits does this thing take? Maybe you just can't kill it like that. Alright, I want to stop obsessing over that thing. There's nothing in those blocks, so I can just mosey on past here. I wonder if the turtle explosion kills other enemies. Probably not. And I'd probably never be able to actually deliberately try to do that. Alright, well, it's been a while, folks. Whoa. I thought for sure I was a dead man there. Oh god. I tried to hit that turtle to see if it would blow those guys up, but no such luck. The Koopa. I mean, I feel weird calling these things Koopas, because Koopas definitely do not explode. I played a lot of Mario games, and there's one thing I know about Koopas. Cylon time. There's one thing I know about Koopas, is that they don't explode. I tried to jump off of the bullet bill, but it didn't work. So yeah, this is like, whoa! Nice! So yeah, this is like an alternate universe where Koopas explode and Mario goes to Japan. Well, this sucks. Whoa. See, it freaks out like that when there's a lot of stuff on the screen, so that's probably what's happening. Pretty sure it's the emulator, not being able to cope with slowdown, I think. Because if I was playing this on an actual Game Boy, I'm pretty sure that would just be a normal slowdown there, not like... Ugh, not this horrible robot noise. Sounds like a 56k modem. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Okay. Oh, that was close. I guess there are some advantages to being tiny. Come on, fall in the hole. I'm gonna see if there's anything in that pipe. Nope. Okay. So yeah, I played this so many times as a kid. At the time, I'm sure I was able to blow through this whole game without dying, which is why I thought it was shorter than it was. Oh god. Oh man. I wanted to jump out of the way of the bomb, but I didn't want to get bulleted. Oh Jesus. Oh my god. That was a lot of those things. I know what those are supposed to be, but I don't know what they're called. Like, I don't know what the name is. Oh, did I? That's weird. I died in the exact spot where, like, I triggered the next checkpoint, and it, like, kind of warped me past a little bit. That was very odd. Alright, well, we've lost a few lives, but we still have 15. So, I'm going to try to go for the flower, if at all possible. Well, 3 extra lives. If I'm not going to get a flower, that's the next best thing. Whoa. I bet I won't be able to jump on that thing. And I'm not going to try, so we'll never know the outcome of that bet. I bet I was right though. Oh my god. Oh Jesus. Oh, this is not gonna be easy. I don't know. No robot! Okay. Whoa. It's like a giant fire-breathing snake. That's pretty cool. Nope. I like that snake. That looks like a cool guy. I wish I could get in there. I bet there's all kinds of good stuff. Wait, did it like... I think it leapt me forward a little bit again. And not being able to scroll the screen backwards, I'm not going to be able to get up there. That's a bummer. Well, I mean, I'll be able to get up there, but only at the very end. Is that turtle gone? I don't want it to come back and juke me. Oh, that is really unpleasant. I wish I knew how to fix that. Well, I thought I timed that better than I did. Oh well. This is pleasant music, so I don't mind spending a little bit of time on this world. I don't know why I did that. I knew there was nothing up there. Welcome. You've got mail. That's what would normally follow that kind of sound effect. Nice. Oh god. Oh, it's one of those radioactive waffles from Super Mario Bros. 3. But the graphics aren't high fidelity enough to really show off the waffleness. So it's more like radioactive grapefruit. Oh, stop it, stop it! Video game, you're killing me! You're killing me softly with your 56k modem noise. Yes! No! Why does it fall off the screen? That's so weird. I guess I didn't want to model the physics of the star bounce. Radioactive grapefruit, part of a well-balanced breakfast. Ooh la la, Mario. Excellent. That was close. Alright, Snake. Alright, Koopa. Oh man, this is not good. This is not good. I didn't jump. Oh, cool. You can, like, make it shoot the fireball up. I made that snake use his own tail. Man, I could go for some waffles and grapefruit right about now. Holy butts, that's a lot of coins. Not really. I don't actually like grapefruit. Waffles, though. Especially, of the Belgian variety. That's pretty good. I don't know, grapefruits are like giant oranges that suck. I don't know why anyone would eat a grapefruit. And I don't know why they call it grapefruit. It doesn't taste like grapes. It doesn't look like a grape. Maybe like baby grapefruit are a different color and they look more like grapes or something. I don't know. Oh, what? I did not mean to do that. That was 100% unintentional. Alright. Come on, flower. I have 250,000 points. That's pretty good. Come on, flower. Three lives. Once again, I cannot complain. Oh, yeah. Oh, man. This is so cool. I don't get why people don't like this game. I'm enjoying it. It's not, you know, it's not too difficult. I mean, I guess, you know. I mean, it is short. I'm pretty sure either World 4 or 5 is the last one. This might be the last episode. I don't actually remember. Oh my god. I like the fact that they fire bullet bills. I don't know, it's weird to see a projectile fired from something that actually shoots bullets. Like a bullet bill. You know, actually being treated like a bullet. Oh. Welp. I don't know. There might be more to this game than I remember. I'm pretty sure it's almost over, though. Well, I'm past the part where you can actually get a big mushroom. Oh no! Wow, those chickens are no fun. I mean, they're not chickens because they're flying, but they look like chickens. Alright, I'm trying not to immediately lose it this time. I wonder if their idea for having Tails fly a plane came from this. In Sonic 2. If there was any inspiration there. Oh no. No, you don't screen. You're not gonna get rid of me that easily. It's our old friend, Mr. Radioactive Grapefruit. Aw, can't go in the pipe. Whoa! It's pipe fists. That's a first. That's like the only time in this whole game that you see those things. Alright, I'm pretty sure this isn't the last boss, so there's at least one more world after this. I forget where the last boss is, actually. I know it's not Bowser. There are no other Mario characters appearing in this game besides Mario and Goomba and the pseudo Koopa. Whoa. Oh, okay, maybe this is the last boss. Oh, jeez. Is that Mighty Bomb Jack? I mean, this sounds like some final boss music. And there's no easy escape in this one like there was in the submarine level. I can't just sneak past him. See, it looks like she's saying both of those things. Huh. My quest is over. Well, that sure was a final boss. That was, I'm gonna be honest with you, that was a little underwhelming. But hey, this music, it's pretty good. Yep, produced by Gunpei Yokoi. Who I believe, I mean, Yokoi was like the mastermind behind the Game Boy. I mean, he was Mr. Game Boy himself. They're actually using their real names, which was a little unusual for this time. That's kind of cool. Man, I'm on a level where I get to fly, this rocket ship. What's an Amida? Huh. I don't know. Thanks, Taki. And thank you, Izushi Nagata. So yeah, like I was saying, I enjoy this game, but it is, I mean, that was what, like, not even an hour, I don't think, total. That was like, 50 minutes, 50-ish, I don't know. So yeah, if I paid full price for this game when it came out, I would have been pretty disappointed. This is not a very, substantial game, but, I mean, it's fun for what it is. I think there was actually a model of the Game Boy that came with this instead of Tetris. I'm not 100% sure though. So, if I got it as a pack-in, I probably would have been less disappointed. So yeah, any second quest or anything? Are all the enemies Buzzy Beetles now? Nope. Alright, well, this has been Let's Play Super Mario Land. I had fun, and this is a good introduction to the Super Mario Land series. I don't know if I'm going to start too immediately. Probably not. But yeah, I will hopefully go through the whole Mario Land / Wario series at some point. So look out for that. That should be fun. And look out for Dungeon Hack coming pretty soon. Don't know when exactly, but keep an eye out on the channel. And thanks for watching, everyone. I will see all of you later. Goodbye.